Well, hello everyone. Welcome to JAM on this Wednesday rainy day. We're glad that you are here. And whenever you have a chance to watch, we are talking about Zacchaeus today, the wee little man. And so you probably know the story at least fairly well. And so I'm excited to hear what Vicar Rick will be bringing us. So let me pray us in. Bless us up. Hey God, it's us kids. You're here, we're here. Today, we're going to sing, we're going to dance, we're going to pray, we're going to learn more about you. In Jesus' name, amen. All right, a couple songs to get us started. Jesus Paid It All by the Newsboys.
He climbed up in a sycamore tree. Hi, everyone.
Yes, you're again.
Yeah, it says this. Can you hear it? Is there anything turned up with it? Test, test. Test, test, test. Test, test. Test, test. Test, test. Test, test, test. There we go. Test, test. Good?
Yep.
All right, there we go. So now, hello everyone. And so, we had to have that song, of course, without a doubt. So we are going to be talking about Zacchaeus today. And we are in the book of Luke, and we are in chapter 19. And so I'm going to read the first two verses. It says, as Jesus was passing through Jericho, a man named Zacchaeus, one of the most influential Jews in the Roman tax collecting business, and of course a very rich man, was there. That was what Zacchaeus was. He was a tax collector. And so that was good for his family because, as it said, he was a rich man, so he was able to provide for his family. But here was the problem. Zacchaeus was a Jewish person. He was collecting taxes from the Jewish people. He worked for the Roman Empire. He worked for the state. And one of the reasons they collected taxes, when you collect taxes, you take money from people. But oftentimes the Roman Empire used that to kind of keep the Jewish people from really being able to have much. They collected so much money from them that it made it hard for the Jewish people to even live, even getting like basic things like food and things. And so Zacchaeus was kind of doing some bad things to his own people, but it was part of his job. So you can guess, do you think Zacchaeus was liked very well? Probably not. Probably not by his own people. But Zacchaeus probably felt bad about it. I mean, they were his own people. But he probably thought a couple of things. First, he had to take care of his family. And that was important. He needed a job. And plus, if he had quit, he maybe thought, well, even if I quit, that's not going to help my people because they'll just find somebody else to take my place. So Zacchaeus was in kind of a tough spot. Maybe felt, well, it's better to at least have a job of some kind, even though I don't like it because I have to take care of my family. Now, have you ever had to do something that was kind of bad to your family because you had to? Think about your parents. You know, when I was little, my parents, you know, they disciplined me, they grounded me, you know, they would punish me if I did something wrong. And maybe you felt this way too, but sometimes I would think, you know, I think my parents must just like to do that. Why did they make me do this? Or why did they punish me for doing that? But as I become a parent, what I found out, when I have to punish my kids, it's almost as hard on me as it is on them. It's hard sometimes for me to maybe take something away, but I do it because it's how I teach them to live in the way God wants to live. So maybe that's what Zacchaeus was thinking too. I don't really like what I'm doing, but I need to take care of and provide for my family. Now, we heard about this in the song, but I'm going to read it in verse 3. He was a rich man. Well, he tried to look at Jesus as Jesus was passing by, but he was too short to see over the crowds. Now, I understand what that means to be short. Pastor Lori is nodding too. We get it. We're both short. So we understand how that feels. Now, if you're short, does that bother you that you're short? Well, sometimes, you know, when I was growing up, it kind of bothered me. I wanted to be taller and tougher, but I just couldn't because I wasn't that big. And so you wonder if maybe Zacchaeus, maybe it bothered him being short. Maybe being a tax collector helped him feel more important, helped him feel bigger. I did that when I was a kid. I tried to be really tough because I was short. I wasn't very good at being tough. So it didn't work out too well. So maybe that's what Zacchaeus did. But one important lesson from this is we have to be who we are. God created us all in a very unique way. And he gave us all different talents and abilities. So if we're shorter than we would like to be, that's okay. We should try to be happy with who we are because God created us that way. Now, as you know, and as Pastor Lori and I know, when you're short, seeing over crowds is a hard thing, especially if you're in the back of the line. And Zacchaeus, it sounds like there were about three rows of people in front of Zacchaeus. That's what he was trying to see through. And if you're short, if you've ever been in a line, you know how it's, you do this, you try to stand on your tiptoes and see, and you just can't. And so we can understand how Zacchaeus felt. But if we had read a little earlier in Luke, in chapter 18, we'd have found out about a different kind of not being able to see, leading up to this story. We think of not being able to see like with our eyes, what's in front of us. Well, at the beginning of the Zacchaeus story, as Jesus was coming into Jericho, he passed a blind man. And of course, if you're blind, you can't see. And as Jesus was walking by, this man heard the people talking about Jesus. So he knew it was Jesus, and he knew Jesus was the Messiah. And so he shouted out for Jesus to heal him. And some people even said, be quiet, stop talking. But he kept yelling more and more, and Jesus heard him and healed him. But even before that, Jesus had been talking to his disciples and telling them that he was going to die, and 3 days later, he would rise again. And his disciples didn't understand what he was talking about. And so the disciples could see Jesus with their eyes. They could see all the miracles that he had done. They were with him as he did all these miracles. But their heart couldn't see. Their heart couldn't see. They couldn't understand what Jesus was talking about. But the blind man, he couldn't see Jesus with his eyes, but he saw Jesus with his heart. He knew who Jesus was and that he could heal him. So sometimes it's not about not being able to see with our eyes, but we also need to see Jesus with our heart as well. So now in verse 4, so he ran ahead and climbed into a sycamore tree beside the road to watch from there. Now Zacchaeus really didn't like crowds. So even going around all those people that had come to see Jesus was difficult. Plus, all those people were in front of him. And so he decided to climb up a tree. Now, does that seem a little strange? I mean, Zacchaeus was a very important man. And he was a grown-up. He wasn't a kid. And here's this grown-up man, very important man, climbing up a tree. Seems a little odd, but you know what? I kind of get Zacchaeus, because for many years, my wife and I and our kid, we went to a place called Door County, Wisconsin, and my wife's uncle had a farm, and in the farm was this tree. And the tree at the top was a little taller than the roof. And I think every year we went, I climbed that tree, and I did it even when I was grown up, because I liked climbing. I still like to climb. If I find some rocks or something, I still like to climb, so I kind of get why Zacchaeus, would do that. But more importantly, Zacchaeus, when he climbed the tree, he wasn't embarrassed, and he wasn't going to worry about if people laughed at him, because he wanted to see Jesus. And so even if people made fun of him because he was grown up, he wanted to see Jesus. And that's another important point. We should never be afraid to try things. What if Zacchaeus wouldn't have climbed up that tree? What if he would have said, oh, this is too embarrassing, I don't think I'll do it? He wouldn't have seen Jesus. So it's good to remember that we should always try things and not worry about being embarrassed about it. So now we're going to play a game. I want you to do something. And we're going to, remember we talked about seeing Jesus with our heart, not just our eyes. And of course, we can't see Jesus here with our eyes. We can see pictures of him. But Jesus, like he wanted the disciples to see, was to see with their heart. So here's what you're going to need. You're going to need either a chair, or if you have some steps in your house, Make sure it's okay with your mom and dad if they let you stand on chairs or if you have a stool, or you can even jump up. But here's what I want you to do. I'm going to list off some people. If you think that they see Jesus, and not with their eyes, but see Jesus with their heart, they know Jesus with their heart. If you think they do, I want you to either run up your steps or stand on top of a chair. Now again, make sure it's okay with your mom and dad if you do that. Or if you just want to jump up in the air, what I want you to do is jump up to the sky, because the higher we get, it's kind of like we're getting closer to heaven, closer to Jesus in heaven. So I want you to do that. Now, if you think these people don't know Jesus in their heart, then I want you to lay on the ground so that we're kind of farther away from Jesus. If you have a chair, you could crawl under the chair, but otherwise just lay down, get as low as you can, okay? So let's see how we do. Let's start out with a robber. If you think they know Jesus in their heart, jump up or run up the steps. And if you need to pause this, good thing about doing it on tape, if you need time to do this and come back, you can pause it and come back. How about a doctor? If you think they see Jesus with their heart and they're close to Jesus, jump up in the air, and if you don't, lay on the floor. How about a fireman? See what you think about that. The next one I'm going to do is a killer. What would you think about that? Jump up or lay down? This is an occupation, but a liar. And I'm not talking about somebody lying on the floor. I'm talking about somebody who doesn't tell the truth. So somebody like that, what do you think of that person? Would they be seeing Jesus with their heart? If you think so, then jump up. And the last person is a pastor. So what do you think of those? So I'm guessing maybe you had a few of each, that some you laid on the floor and some you maybe jumped up and down. What if I told you that the answer for all of these could be either one? Does that surprise you? Do you know there are some people that maybe have killed somebody or done something really bad who ended up being able to see Jesus with their heart? And they accepted him. And of course, Jesus forgave them, even though they did some very bad things. Do you also know that pastors sometimes fall away from Jesus? Now we think, well, how can that be? Sometimes pastors have done really bad things where they've forgotten or ignored what they know Jesus has taught them to do. So this list of people, some sounding really good, some sounding really bad, but all of us can find Jesus. We can all see him with our heart. And no matter what we've done, he'll forgive us. And even the best of us, and sometimes in the Bible, some people thought they were so important that they were close to Jesus. Well, that's not true, because we all sin. Even the best of us, we all fall away from time to time. But the good news is Jesus always forgives all of us, no matter what we've done. And it's important to remember, too, that as hard as we try, we still are going to do some things that might not please Jesus, because we're human and we do sin sometimes. Okay, so now to verses 5 and 7, 5 through 7. Zacchaeus hurriedly climbed down and took Jesus to his house. Oh, I'm sorry, I missed. I have a hard time reading this Bible. When Jesus came by, he looked up at Zacchaeus and called him by name. Zacchaeus, he said, quick, come down, for I'm going to be a guest at your home today. Zacchaeus hurriedly climbed down and took Jesus to his house in great excitement. But the crowds were displeased. He has gone to be the guest of a notorious sinner, they grumbled. Why do you think Jesus wanted to go to Zacchaeus' house? Well, probably for the same reason that we've been talking about. Jesus often went to those people that others thought were sinners, those people that others, the people who thought they were important, kind of pushed off to the side. And so it made perfect sense that Jesus would go to Zacchaeus' house, because Jesus was a friend of all the tax collectors who people thought were sinners, and all the people that others thought did bad things. And then we go to verses 9 and 10, actually 8 through 10. And meanwhile, Meanwhile, Zacchaeus stood before the Lord and said, "Sir, from now on, I will give half my wealth to the poor. And if I find I've overcharged anyone on his taxes, I will penalize myself by giving him back four times as much." And Jesus said, "Salvation has come to this home." Zacchaeus had been kind of a little crooked. You know, he had been helping the Roman Empire, but he had been making it really hard on people. Well, now he was going to give half of all his money, and he was rich, to the poor. And if he cheated someone, out of $1, he was going to give them $4 back. Do you think Zacchaeus quit his job? Probably not. We don't know for sure. But what we do know is Zacchaeus found out that it wasn't the job that was important. Sometimes we think the job we have is what makes us important. It was knowing Jesus that mattered. Have you ever tried to do something that you thought would make you feel better? Like if I do something really well, or if I get a new bike, or those things that you think, if I get that, I'm going to feel really good, but yet you still feel a little empty? Well, the emptiness is what Jesus fills. Even when we get these things that we think are really great, sometimes we still don't quite feel right. And that's what Zacchaeus found out. That as important as he was, there was still something missing, and that was knowing Jesus. Jesus fills that void that we have. And one other thing. We think